So I've had a nice day off. It's Thursday. I decided to ride Stella up to Prescott, come up through 89. So now I'm on the way home, heading out of Prescott. Had a nice lunch at Prescott Brewery. Had a real good sandwich there. Chicken breast sandwich marinated in jalapeno something. Hey buddy, stay in your lane, watch what you're doing. Then it had some sort of jalapeno mayonnaise sauce and jalapeno infused bacon on ciabatta bread, but I didn't eat the bread. And I was a good girl, I didn't even eat fries, I had a garden salad instead. Goodbye. Get out of my way. Yeah, he's not paying attention. Watch out for this truck here. Make sure he sees me. Yeah. Had a bit of a close call on the way here. The only reason I'm even going to talk about it is a reminder to other riders how to always be looking for a way out and always anticipate what the drivers are going to do. Not that I'm perfect. I mean, I know there's probably been times I've caught off guard or got distracted, but so for those of you in the local area, when you're coming the 101 to the 17, take the 17 north, there's that transition point where everybody in the left wants to suddenly get over in the right to get onto the 17 north, and there's traffic merging onto the 101 that wants to get onto the left lanes to go to the 17 south or to keep going on the 101. I've come through there a few times and been nearly clipped, so I'm super alert when I come through that section. So I was approaching it this morning going west on the 101. I get over in the right lane to take the exit, but I see that there's a lot of traffic in line to merge onto the freeway. So I move over one lane to the left to minimize merging traffic pulling into me. Hey guys. And it's pretty clear. My thought was I'm going to move over to one lane over, let the traffic merge in, and then I'll get back over in my exit lane. So I'm in the second lane over from the right, and I see a big, big utility trucks. He's coming up in the lane next to me, and he comes up behind me, and pulls up beside me, and all of a sudden I see him drifting, and I'm like, he's getting too close to the line. So I scooted over. I was on the far right of the lane next to him, so I wasn't right next to him, and I noticed he was starting to come over. So I simultaneously went back, scooted back over into the other lane, because I knew that was my escape route, because I... and laid on the horn. So I don't know if he just didn't realize that I had changed lanes or what, but he could have gotten me. If I had been on the left side of my lane, he would have gotten me. But I was riding the right side so that I could get back over into the merge lane. So I'm just glad that I was focused and paying attention and very aware of traffic patterns in that area. So yeah, just be careful. Always assume they're going to not see you and they're going to cut you off. You just have to assume that. ridden almost, I've ridden 13,780 some miles since I got Stella. So I'm a lot more comfortable on these kinds of roads and stuff, but I'm not a speed demon. I have people pass me all the time, make sure this guy's okay. He motions that he's okay. All right. Don't know what I'd do if I had stopped, but I could telephone for help. Mostly just people stopping and taking a break, taking pictures, but you're supposed to never pass a biker that might be in distress without checking on them. I see a lot of bikes on this road, and I try to do the wave, but sometimes I'm not going to because I'm not going to take my hand off the handlebar. But anyway, I've gotten a lot more comfortable on these roads. I like them. I actually enjoy it. Now, I remember the first couple times on something like this, I was just like freaking out, going 20 miles an hour in a 30 mile an hour zone. So I still will ride like that. Sign says 25 miles an hour. I'm probably gonna do it at 30. I won't go more than that. But I mean, I'm telling you, I used to, if that sign said 25, I was doing 20. I just don't see a need to be in a hurry. I know some really get a thrill from zipping through curves, especially at the sport bikes. I'm sure that's a different experience. But I'm on a big old Harley. And I'm not in a hurry. I just want to enjoy the ride, enjoy the scenery, enjoy the curves, lean the bike some, which I used to never do. It took me a while to get comfortable leaning the bike. Now I enjoy it. The only thing about riding these kind of roads on a motorcycle is you really can't enjoy the scenery too much. I'm trying to turn my head once in a while, let the camera catch the view, but my eyes have to be absolutely on the road. I can't be looking off to the left right now because I know there's a beautiful view off to the left right now, but my eyes got to be looking where I'm going. So that's another reason for the camera, is so that I can watch it myself. Anyhow, I know I go slower than some bikes, but that was 38, and it said 35, and I was doing 38, so I don't think I'm such a turtle like I used to be, but I still have bike. I'm not surprised if cars pass me. I still have bikes pass me on these kinds of roads, and that's fine. I let them pass. I try to just move over and signal to them and say, go ahead, be safe. I believe the number one, maybe it's number two, but I believe the number one reason for fatality on motorcycle accidents is because they took a corner, is going around curve, took it too fast, or lost their sight, their line of sight. And I'm very much aware of that, and I don't want to be one of those statistics. That's why I make sure that I'm going slow around these little curves. Although, it looks like I was going about 30. I don't think I was going 30. That's a tight one right here. Yeah, there's some breathtaking views over there. And then by the time I see a spot where I can pull over, it's too late to safely stop, get myself situated, so I don't. Just keep going. And the pullouts along this road, they're all gravel. So like, that sucks. I will not go in gravel unless I absolutely have no choice, because I don't like it. It's too much of a risk to tip. Well, right, see, like right there. Be a nice little lookout stop. Take a picture. I'm not pulling off into that gravel because I'd probably dump the bike. I'd probably be stupid and pull the front brake even though I know not to. And I'd probably dump the bike, and here I'd be out in the middle of nowhere waiting for some kind soul to come along and pick up my 800-pound bike. So gotta be ready for the Devil's Highway ride in a week and 2 days. What is that, 100 and some miles of twisty roads? Supposedly like this. Ugh. This is only 15 miles. This section is only 15 miles like this. So I don't know how I'm gonna do 100 and some miles of this. I think that's the... But you stop a lot, that's my understanding. You stop and take breaks a lot. My friends have done it. They've assured me that I can do it. And we just take our time. I figured today would be good practice. That's why I'm doing this road up and back. Thing is, I gotta not tense up. I have to relax. It's a whole different perspective coming back. Oh, there's that snake. Ooh, that's a rattler, a big one. I saw him on the way up. I remember as I approached him, I saw that Facebook video that somebody put where a guy drives by a motorcycle on a snake and lifts his feet up because a snake strikes at him and almost would have got him in the boot. Of course, in the boot, you know. But I remember that Facebook video. I'm like, okay. I've seen a few snakes in the road when I've been riding. And sometimes the thought is ride over them because I don't like snakes. But if it was out here, they do serve a purpose. So I probably would not purposely ride over it. And besides, if I caught its tail, it could probably still turn and strike me. I don't know, but I saw that video, I was like, yikes. So when I was coming up on the way and I saw that snake in the road, I didn't know, it wasn't real clear at when I came through if it was dead or not. So I moved over. And I moved over far enough and I did lift my feet just a little bit. Even though I have boots on up to my shins, or there's a little gravel. I have boots on that cover almost up to my knee, but still, you know. Although maybe it would have been cool then, I could have had my own Facebook video of a snake striking at me while I ride by. Nah, I think I'd rather not. Anyway, he's clearly dead. Look at that scenery over there, man. Coming up behind me, so I might if he closes the gap, I'll move over and just wave him by because I am taking my time. This is a kind of fun one, especially being on the inside curve. Coming up, I was on the outside with that drop off, but that always spooks me a little bit. Yeah, this guy's coming up on me, so I'm gonna have to let him by here. They appreciate that, you know. show them some respect. Help them to have respect for us. It goes both ways. I love it. You get a sign, tells you 35 or 45, and you got cool. Shift up, and then you watch. I just bet you, as soon as you get around here, there's a 20 mile an hour sign. So, yeah, it tells you, okay, here's the speed limit, and then, but no, now you gotta slow down for the curb. Also, since I'm on the inside of this road, I'm also watching for loose gravel from these rocks. Don't want to come around a curve. And have there be... I mean, it's not a terrible thing, but you just want to be aware of it. So. And like Shelley says, when in doubt, give us a throttle. Got some nasty stuff here. I know those little bumps in the road are not going to cause me to go down. I just still don't like hitting them in a curve. It's a psychological thing. I mean, unless they were really deep, I suppose it's not gonna like cause me to like fall over, but it's still just, I'd prefer not to hit them when I'm turning or leaning the bike. Those guys that ride bicycles up and down these roads, man, gotta hand to them. Ooh, there's a... They gotta be in shape. I realize that they've got bikes with a lot of gears to, you know, help them when they're pedaling up, but dang. One. Miles to Wickenburg, 102 to Phoenix. I'm not going that route to Phoenix, but probably a little bit more for me. I'm going over to Scottsdale, but nice ride today. Nice and cool up here. Well, it's been cool the whole ride. It's probably going to be warm when I get back into the valley, though. about down. I'm only riding the yellow line because of the bumpiness in the middle, and there's no cars here. You had some road damage since the last time I rode it. Of course, last time I rode it was before winter, so that makes sense. There's a truck behind me. I'll let him go by in a second here. Yeah.